where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls, where words come out from the depth of truth, where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way to the dreary desert sand of dead habit, where the mind is led forward by thee into ever-widening thought and action, to that heaven of freedom, my Father, let my country awake. With these words of Rabindranath Tagore, let me wish you all a good morning and a happy Independence Day. India is celebrating its 72nd Independence Day to pay tribute to all countrymen, all brave hearts who showed their valor, never turned their backs in making the supreme sacrifice for our nation. Also to all the uniformed forces maintaining safety and security of our nation. In 3000 years of our history, people from all over the world have come and invaded us, captured our lands and conquered our minds. From Alexander onwards, the Greeks, the Turks, the Mughals, the Portuguese, the British, the French and the Dutch. All of them came and looted us, took over what was ours. Yet, we have not conquered any other nation. We have not grabbed their lands, culture, history, and we have not tried to enforce our way of life on them. As a country, we have respected the freedom of others. I do feel from my heart that I should use this opportunity to share certain things with all of you. We complain that our government is inefficient, our laws are too old, municipality does not pick up the garbage, railway timings are a joke, etc. We say. What can we do about it? When Arjuna was posing a lot of queries to Lord Krishna in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, Krishna told Arjuna, we achieve our goals as per our thinking and beliefs. We have a strong determination. We are committed for a brighter India. We, who have grown up in the state of hopelessness, must now reject the feeling of despair and march ahead with confidence. We should leave the chalta hai attitude. We should believe we can bring in the change. This attitude will help us as a nation. We should have this confidence, work hard, and a resolve to do something. To bring in a big transformation and accomplishment. Ask what we can do for India and do what has to be done to make India what other developed countries are today. This quote of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam keeps haunting in my mind. I request one and all to take a pledge along with me to make the missile man's dream come true. I want to live in a developed India. I will have to build this developed India. I must proclaim, India is not an underdeveloped nation. It is a highly developed nation. Jai Hind!